हेलो, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। Hello, assalamu alaikum. Do you see the screen? Is it visible to all of you? Okay, fine. That's great. Okay, now we are going to discuss over the topic, art and beauty as an aesthetic. All right, and I have posted no assignment yet for this week. You have to do your the previous assignment. If someone has already done it, then he will just go for the reading of this from this slides. Okay. Today's topic is about the aesthetic. Aesthetic is one of the branch of philosophy, and this branch is belongs to the axiology. Do you remember that? What is axiology? Axiology is the question of the value, and here we are talking about the aesthetic value, individual value, and the topic is called the value about the art and the beauty. Which one is said to be beautiful, and which one is an art? What is an art? What is in beauty? And is beauty lies in the eyes of beholder? Is a matter of fact, or is a matter of taste? And what should be the purpose of art? Why the art is important in our daily life? And is there any relationship between the art and the beauty, or why we add up in the philosophy? There is some relation of philosophy or as within art. So the philosophy of art is called the aesthetic, and why this philosophy is needed? Approximately 200 years ago, this one become a part of the philosophy and known as an aesthetic. And what we deal in is statistic. In statistic, we deal with the art, we deal with the beauty, we will deal the value and the taste about a human. So this one is a youngest branch, a stepchild of philosophy, is the youngest branch of the philosophy. And modern art has a modern literature, and contemporary philosopher and the modern philosopher have contributed too many on the artistic values. So here is a debate over that. What would we call an art? What is an art? What is actually an art? If I ask a question, okay, why? What is an artist about? So art is what? Art is an expression of emotion. Art is expression of your innermost thought. Art is an expression of innermost feeling. It is a reflection of your moment of the emotion. At that moment, what is the flow of emotion? It will be well expressed through the medium of art. Exactly. And what is art according to you? What is an art? Art is an expression. Art is an expression of your innermost thought and feeling. Art is an expression of your innermost thought and the feeling. It's all about your innermost expression. It is deep inside you. Where your words limit, when you do not express by the word, where the art comes from. Art go beyond your imagination, art beyond your words. Art reflect those things, those parts which cannot be expressed in terms of words. So art is very expressive, artist is very expressive, and artist has a skill to express their emotion as well as the emotion of the other. Art is an expression of the human mind and the emotion. And you will see through the artistic skills what we lack in a rationality or in a reason. So when we talk about the emotion, so emotion can easily speak through the forms of art. And as we know that we have different forms of art. We have dancing, we have performance art, we have poetry, we have opera, we have for theater, melodrama, lyrics, songs, painting, skydiving, gymnastics, pose, athletes, many forms of arts are there. And someone in the modern days say that teaching is also an art, acting is also an art, is a performance art, marketing is an art, art of influencing other, communication is an art of persuading other, business is an art of getting money together. So what is an art? Art is a skill set. Art is a skill set. Art is your imagination. Art is a speaking of your emotion. So through the art, you will discover the beauty. You will reflect the beauty through the art, and art connect the people together with their meaning. There is a lot of secret meaning behind the artistic work. All right. So here is more definition regarding the art. Yes, art is an expression. Expression of what? Expression. Whenever we talk about the art, we have three words in our mind: creativity, skills, and imagination. And art is expression of all of them. Art is an expression of creativity, whatever the ideas that you hold in mind. Through your skill set, through your imagination, you will plot it, you will portray it. Through your script, through your painting, through your writing, through your vlog, through your blog, through your photography, these are the modern form of art. Fashion designer, interior designer, architect designer, photography, vlogs, YouTubers, content creator, all these are the modern form of art. But this is a commercial art, this is a modern art, this is an instrumental art. But art is a mean, art is a medium to join together with the meaning. They are expressive of emotions and the feeling, right? Leo Tolstoy say art is a union of among the men, joining them together in the same feeling, and it shows the feelings of other. And arts show the well-being of individual and humanity. And another definition is that art is a discovery. Discovery of what? Discovery of beauty, discovery of principle of nature, discovery and exploring those parts which cannot be understood through the mind. Art is a transcendental experience. Transcendental means that is go beyond the limitation. So some religious, some spiritual connections are also there, and there is some inner emotional attachment are also embedded in an art. So artist is so much connected with the spirituality, emotion, instincts, association, and their experiences, and the personal experiences are well portrayed in an art. In a common man and the artist has a major difference is that a common man is not able to express their things, but artist is very effective to deliver their thing. Yeah, art is a discovery of what? Art is a discovery of new thing. Art is a discovery of a reality also. Those mysteries and those reality which cannot be understood through the mind or through the rational reason. So art is a discovery. Art is a reflection of irrational part, irrational belief. So art is too much connected with your instincts, your gut feeling, your emotions, your heart. Your heart speaks through the art. So that's why artists is very imaginative, very emotional, very sensitive. They use this sensitivity to explore their words. Exactly. Yes. Ehsaas o jazbaat ko hum yun lafzon mein dal dete hain aur log sirf ise lafzon ka majmua samajh kar dal dete hain. What does it mean? Yani all the feeling is a reflection of your heart, and you will do writing from your core heart. It shows your deep insight, it shows your deep thought emotions. Okay, where we are. So art is not a way. Art is a way. Is not a way. It is a way. It is a way of what? I will tell you. It is a way of expressing. It is a way of discovering. It is a way of exploring yourself. Okay, fine. What is an aesthetic? Aesthetic is a branch of axiology. Question of the value judgment is a value of art in the form of many different content like audio, video, music, dance, poetry, movies, drama, animated movies, scripted content, book writing, poetry, lyrics, all these are the form. And when we want to study the nature of art, which one is most beautiful, which one is good, which one is bad, and what does it mean behind all these. So when we study about all these things, when we study about the nature of arts, nature of beauty, and the nature of taste and choices, because taste and choices matter a lot in aesthetic. If you say that this sound good for me, not necessarily this one is good for another, because it's a matter of perception, it's a matter of taste and choices. So what is an aesthetic? Aesthetic is a study about the art, beauty, and the taste. And here is a debate, here is a critical question in a philosophy, whether the art and beauty lies in the eyes of beholder, khoobsurti dekhne wale ki sirf aankh mein hai, ya koi shay bazaate khud bhi khoobsurat hoti hai. Beauty lies in the eyes of beholder only, or the beauty itself is enough and no need to explain. There is only interpretation, there is no fact. Any interpretations happen, interpretation makes the thing beautiful. This, the whole universe is not a beautiful, the human mind is beautiful, that gives the lot of beautiful interpretation to explore and explain all this. So we have two position. One position is said that beauty and art lies in the eyes of beholder, and another position is that no in the eyes of the beholder, it is the object, it is a fact. Rose itself is a beautiful flower. If you don't like the rose, it doesn't mean the rose is not beautiful. Whatever the opinion, the perception regarding the rose is, but rose collectively known as a beautiful one. But if you say that I don't like the color red, I'll itch by their smell, I will hate that rose because of my some emotional connection. So this is not the way. This is only your perception. So rose itself is a beautiful. If you saw a beautiful lake, but you don't like, but you will just click one half of them, so it does not show the whole picture. The art and beauty is in the eyes of beholder. No, not only in the eyes of beholder, is objectify itself. The beauty is objective. If you don't like those things, it doesn't mean that it is not beautiful. I think you are blind. I think you are biased. I think it may be you are not well experienced and you have no knowledge of it. That's why you will completely neglect it. If someone see the painting in art gallery and say, what the hell is going there? These are too much color mass on that board. But there is an abstract art. An abstract art has some mystery. Abstract art has some sense of content and the craft are there. And but those who have a better understanding about the art, they will be a value of that art. But another way he say that this one is not a good art. Okay, exactly. So beauty lies not only in the eyes of beholder. This one is the one position, and beauty lies in the eyes of beholder is the another position. Okay, we will start. I'll take up another definition, and then we'll be discuss later on about the subjectivity and objectivity of the art and beauty. What is beauty about? So beauty, whenever we word the use of beauty, the beauty is not only associated with the person. Beauty is associated with the nature, with the places, with the event, with the object, with the idea, with the word, with the content, and also with the character of a person. So beauty is not only the nomina. Beauty is also the phenomena. Beauty sirf zahiri nahi hai, sirf appearance and attire nahi hai. Beauty is also your insight. So what is beauty about? So beauty is what, when you see the dictionary, you will say that beauty is ripe up the fruit, and it will be decline after the some period of time. Those things which look so beautiful right now, but after a certain time it will be decline. It lose some importance and sense of feeling there. When you are in a good mood, you will keep enjoy your coffee. But when you are depressed and in a saddest mood, that coffee make you more irritating. So this is the perception also. So what is beauty about? So beauty is a perception. Beauty is a matter of choice, or beauty itself is beauty. No need to explain the concept of beauty. Beauty is just for feel experience. So what is beauty about? So here is a lot of definition. Beauty is that type of qualities, a person, a place or object or any idea that hold and that give pleasure to your senses. And how many senses you have? Everyone knows that we have our five senses, five bodily senses are there, to see, to hear, to tongue, to eye, and to touch. When they give you some sense of pleasure, that make the thing that makes you beautify. And this will, that product is said to be was aesthetically sound. I have a phone, and you see that phone, you see that what a great design, what a beautiful phone it is. So why you say that this is a very beautiful? Because it seems look to catch, it seems look to see, it keep good when you hear from that voice. So you say that this sound is very beautiful. Why you say that this is beautiful? It is beautifier because this product is attaining the attribute and quality that please me. So what is the beauty? Beauty that give pleasure, that give pleasure to your senses and also your mind. When you need, when you get some mental satisfaction, when you read a story, when you read a book, and you will say that, wow, what a wonderful, beautiful book it is. What a beautiful content, what a beautiful idea that book contains. So that book give you pleasure. But which kind of pleasure? Intellectual pleasure, mental satisfaction. So what is the definition of beauty? Beauty that give you pleasure, bodily pleasure or the mental satisfaction. It is a perceptual experience of the pleasure. So in a simple way, you can say that beauty is perceptual experience of pleasure. Beauty is the thing that gives you pleasure, whether to your senses, whether to your mind. It gives you satisfaction. It gives you meaning. So this is a definition of beauty. And we have more definition. We have more approaches of beauty here. Beauty is a sensual pleasure, as I told you before, that give you the only bodily pleasure, that give you the only not only the mental senses, but give you the pleasure to your senses. And the second one is what? When we say that this product is beautiful, this laptop is very beautiful, why you say that? Why you say that this laptop is beautiful? Because you say that it is very slick, it is very, its configuration is very good, its color is so attractive, it is very portable, is very smart and limp. Okay, fine. You have to describe some future. When you find this future, you say that this one is beautiful. Which pen is beautiful? You say that it is very easy grip and the ink is very legible to us and very eye-catching and that hold a wonderful bright color. So these show the some attributes. So what is beauty? Whenever you have a mind, concept of beauty in your mind, you will admire some position of some future. Whenever you say this person is beautiful, so you have some attribution in your mind. If all these things are match up with someone, you say this one is beautiful and this one is not, this one is ugly. So beauty and ugly has some future, and that futures make the things the beautiful, right? Exactly. Or you can say that this future is very varying from culture to culture, person to person, it vary. Someone like that future and someone like that not future, in it depend on the culture, depend on the places, is a relative term. Third one is harmony with the nature. Beauty is those things that relate with the nature. And as we know that originality and the nature is beautiful. The replica, imitation and copy is never be a beautiful. The original nature is beautiful. Original nature means the law of nature. Nature, lake, mountain, river, cloud. All these are the great design of the great designer. And all these nature fascinated you. Whenever you want to be refresh yourself, you go for hiking, you will go for the natural places. And they will give you some sort of positive energy and vibes into you. So beauty is what? Beauty is harmony with the nature. When you go flow with the nature, it will give you some sense of beautiness. Another position is that beauty is an order. Beauty is a proportion, is a mathematical order. when you arrange the things in a proper order, in a proper manner, in a geometrical shape like oval, like square, like triangular, like linear scale, whenever you arrange the glass and arrange all those chair in a row and column form, and with the contrast of the color, blue and the black and the red and the white, you see that this class shows some aesthetic sound. This will show the beautiful class, what a beautiful class it is. So the order and the proportion of anything, when we see the pattern of that whole universe, we see that there is a center place which is called the sun, and their orbit around, there is a 9 planet are there, and they all are arranged in some certain ordered in the proportion. So everything that is in the order, everything is in that place, the right thing at the right place, and the right place at the right thing, it seems like a beautiful thing. If you align, if you order, if you arrange things in the form of size, color, shape, numbers, you will see that things become a so beautiful or the ugly. Another definition, beauty is a reflection of your own existence. Who you are, what do you feel, what do you think? What is your subconscious mind speed? What your unconscious mind try to say you? If you want to know, if you want to know your secret, if you want to know your mystery, if you want to understand your psychopathy, so you will use an art. Nowadays, psychotherapists use the artistic work because everyone has some habit to draw some signs, some colors, some shapes, and some pattern. And this sort of pattern, whenever you see the dust on the car, you will draw a certain design. Everyone has a habit to draw a mark, some design and some picture and some logo at the end of the their notebook. This one show your unconscious mind. This one show your memories. This one shows you some mysteries regarding about you. So artwork sometimes reflect your own existence. It explore those parts which you are not aware of. Artist is very, very exploring one about yourself. So art is a reflection of your own existence. Another definition, beauty and art is the fulfillment of purpose, achievement of goal, achievement of your desire, and accomplishment of any task, everything that makes you closer to your purpose and the goal. So that one become beautiful for you. You say this one is very beautiful for me. Why this one is beautiful? Because it will assess me, it will help me to achieve my goal, my desire, and my purpose. So the beauty is fulfillment of purpose. Beauty is providing help to achieve our goal. And another definition, beauty is an imitation of the nature. Law of nature, the nature itself is beautiful, and beauty is imitated. Beauty is the manifesto, an exploration of the nature. And the last one is that beauty is God. Why we say that beauty is God? God is perfect. God is absolute. God is a designer. God is a great designer. The whole world, the whole universe, every planet is designed. Everything is designed by some designer. And there is a design, there must be a designer. And here the designer is the God. God is a great designer. God is a perfect being. God is an absolute being. He arranged that thing. When we say that nature is beautiful, who makes that nature beautiful? God created this nature so beautiful. He uses the color, he allocated the proper order, he made the things perfect. And the most important thing is that everyone is trying to become a perfect one. And when you want to pursue the perfectness and those things that you feel lack in yourself, that makes you lovable, that makes you beautiful. And you say that this person is beautiful, this book is beautiful, this thing is beautiful. Basically, this thing is lacking you and you want to get it. You want to possess, you want to get possession. Because of what? Because you want to try to become a perfect. You will want to be idealized yourself. That's why that thing is attractive to you. If someone is very boring person and someone find the company of a person, those who have a very great sense of humor, so he want to get, because the human want to fulfill and fill up the lackness of the thing. So whatever you lack and you want to get back from the others, from the things, and that things make you beautiful. In a simple way, all those things that you fill up, that you make up a perfection, that you make up a perfection or idealist one, That one is also beautiful. So this one is a this one is a many multiple approaches of a beauty. I will explain the beauty now. Do you have any reflection regarding the beauty? Yes, beauty is an expression and application of human critical imagination, aesthetic. Aesthetic is a branch of philosophy in which we study about the art, beauty, and the taste. Done? Okay, fine. Now we are going to debate over the theme that art and beauty lies in the beholder, or art and beauty is not lies in the eyes of the beholder. Is beauty is subjective, or is beauty is objective? Yes, it's a matter of fact, or is a matter of choice? What is your opinion? Beauty is a matter of fact. Beauty, its object itself is beautiful, or beauty is a matter of choice, is a matter of taste. What do you think? What is your opinion? Beauty is subjective or objective? Okay, it is a matter of opinion. Abdul Majeed says a matter of opinion. It means you are going toward the subjective point of view. Is a matter of choice, again the same, the matter of opinion, matter of choice, it means the subjective point of view. Mushi said the both, subjective or objective. Okay. You say the both. Asan Ali say it is both. Beauty is subjective or as well as the objective. Okay. Is a matter of choice. Okay, fine. Now we will open the debate. Those who believe that it is a matter of fact, beauty is not a matter of choice, it is not a matter of opinion, whether you like or whether you don't like, whether you interpret, whether you don't interpret, the things itself is beautiful. The thing itself is beautiful due to its originality, due to its essential contemporary essence. They have some essence, they have some attribute, and that essence and that essentials make the things beautiful. If a statue is beautiful and then someone who does not like, doesn't mean that that statue become ugly. That statues remain doesn't mean the thing is not remains a beautiful. The thing itself remains a beautiful. If you don't like the color red and you see the red and you have a different perception, you feel the phobia and fear when you see the red. So whenever you see the red things, you say that this one is not good. No, red itself is something. So object is very important. Object is a matter of fact. So beauty is the property of the universe. Is the property of the universe. Is in the object. So we have to be find out what kind of object we have to be determined. So someone say size, shape, color, harmony, proportion, distance. These are the thing. And it means those